Elvis Presley, an iconic figure known for his captivating performances and larger-than-life presence, had a life shrouded in mystery and controversy. As the years went by, the once vibrant and energetic performer began to transform into a shadow of his former self. Onlookers and critics, unaware of the severe illnesses plaguing him, dismissed his changing appearance as mere weight gain. Little did they know, Elvis was battling a silent war within his body. Elvis' health deteriorated rapidly, and his illnesses became a burden that affected his career. He was forced to cancel shows and even put on shorter performances due to his declining condition. It was a far cry from the energetic and vibrant performances that had made him a legend. Colonel Tom Parker, Elvis' manager, started to see him as more of a liability than an asset. The personal tensions between the two men, coupled with Elvis' declining attendance at shows, took a toll on their professional relationship. Parker, driven by financial interests, began to see Elvis as a problem rather than the iconic performer he once was. The mid-1970s marked a turning point in their relationship. Parker, desperate for an exit strategy, attempted to sell his share of the contract just before Elvis' death. His efforts were in vain, but it highlighted the strained dynamics between the two. Elvis, feeling controlled and restricted, believed that Parker was meddling in every aspect of his life. The once symbiotic relationship had turned sour, and Parker was ready to cut ties. As if Elvis' health and professional struggles weren't enough, his personal life was also in turmoil. The divorce between his father, Vernon Presley, and his second wife, Devota D. Stanley, had a devastating impact on the entire family. Vernon, in an attempt to protect his own interests, took legal measures to ensure that Elvis' finances remained separate. This involved complex legal maneuvers, which further strained the already fragile family dynamics. The Stanley boys, Billy, Ricky, and David, found themselves in a difficult position. Their mother's divorce from Elvis' father created a rift within the family, and their loyalty was tested. As employees of Elvis, they had to navigate the delicate balance between their personal lives and their professional duties. The tension was palpable, and the situation only worsened as rumors of payroll cuts circulated. Vernon's actions had far-reaching consequences. In an effort to completely sever ties with Dee Stanley and her sons, he had to make some drastic decisions. The Stanley boys, along with many of Elvis' employees and family members, were named in Elvis' will. Vernon, in a cruel twist, wanted to remove everyone from the will, except for himself and Elvis' daughter, Lisa Marie. Elvis, known for his generosity, trusted his father implicitly. When Vernon convinced him that changing the will would protect him, Elvis agreed without question. Little did he know that this decision would cause a rift within his own family and create a sense of betrayal among those closest to him. The will was amended on March 3, 1977, and the witnesses, including Charlie Hodge and Ginger Alden, were left in a difficult position. Ginger Alden, Elvis' girlfriend at the time, was one of the witnesses. She unknowingly played a role in revealing the truth about the will to the Stanley brothers. When they learned that they had been excluded along with the rest of Elvis' family, anger and resentment boiled over. Billy Smith, his wife Jo, and Elvis' aunt, Delta Mee, were outraged. The Stanley brothers, feeling wronged and insulted, were determined to seek justice. Dan Warlick, an investigator, had his suspicions about the events surrounding Elvis' last night. He noticed the fear in the eyes of the maids at Graceland, and he believed that something more sinister was at play. The possibility of a conspiracy involving Elvis' aunt and his closest confidants began to unfold. In 1976, Elvis' financial situation took a turn for the worse. Vernon, assuming the role of both father and financial advisor, made some questionable decisions. The firing of Elvis' longtime bodyguards, Red West, Sonny West, and Dave Hebler, was a move that would have severe consequences. These men, known for their loyalty and trustworthiness, were abruptly let go without warning. Vernon's actions created a rift within Elvis' inner circle. The bodyguards, feeling betrayed and angry, directed their resentment towards Elvis himself. They refused to believe that Elvis was facing financial troubles and saw Vernon's actions as a personal attack. Elvis, despite his efforts to make amends and offer financial support, couldn't repair the damage that had been done. As Elvis' health continued to decline, so did his ability to perform and generate income. The massive payroll, lack of tax shelters, and an unfair financial agreement with Colonel Parker put a strain on his finances. Elvis was working tirelessly to entertain his fans, but it came at a cost to his personal wealth. Vernon, in an attempt to keep his son afloat, made some bold decisions, but the firing of the bodyguards was a step too far. The aftermath of this decision left a bitter taste in the mouths of those close to Elvis. The once united front of his entourage began to fracture. The bodyguards, feeling a sense of betrayal, directed their anger towards Elvis, the very person they had dedicated their lives to protecting. As the pieces of the puzzle came together, a darker picture began to emerge. The events leading up to Elvis' death were shrouded in controversy and suspicion. The amendment of his will, the firing of loyal bodyguards, and the strained family dynamics all contributed to a sense of unrest. Elvis, the king of rock and roll, was battling not only his declining health, but also the complexities of his personal life and the people around him.